Thank you. Thank you. concert this year since we were shut down, and I'm so grateful for that, so thank you for coming out. But it's not our last performance in here. There's one more required concert, if you look on your, well, concert performance that is on your program, and that is graduation on June 4th. So just bear that in mind. Tonight's concert is really about the seniors. It's about recognizing the seniors and their accomplishments, as well as giving out lettering awards. And so the students, for the first time, are going to find out who we are, which is pretty exciting. And also some of our top, well, all of our top band awards tonight. We're also going to feature some solos and ensembles that were featured at our virtual district music festival, which was quite an experience. Ask me about it after the concert tonight. I'd be happy to share it with you. It was great. It was wonderful. You can tell my sarcasm here. All right. So moving right along here, this is our Jazz One. 3.5 weeks ago, we had a concert with just jazz bands and percussion. In fact, exactly 1 month ago, we had a band concert. Can you believe that? And in 3.5 weeks' time, we are back in this room performing once again. So these students tonight, everything you're going to hear tonight, with the exception of the solos and ensembles from District Festival, have only had 3.5 weeks of preparation, and these students have done a great deal to get this done, and they've done it so well. I wish we had 2 more weeks to tighten some things up, but man, I think you're going to be really impressed. This next tune is going to feature one of our faculty members here at Flathead High School in Glacier. He is our guitar instructor, he's a good friend, and he's part of our music program. I'd like to introduce to you Mr. Steve Eccles on guitar. This is a shuffle called 17 Mile Drive.
Thank you.
Mr. Tanner Crow on drum sax. On the drum set, Mr. Grayson Malone. Well done, you guys. All right, this last piece is a contemporary piece. It's called Birdland, and it was originally recorded by Weather Report and then re-recorded many times. And one in particular that's a really great version is by the famous trumpet player Megan Ferguson, and this is based on that. So I think you'll enjoy this. This will feature on solos, improvised solos, Connor Mullins on tenor, and Alan McLaughlin on alto saxophones, all seniors. So here is Birdland. everybody. So, on your program, you'll notice there are two ensembles. Actually, the first one is a soloist. This is Parker Stocklin. He did a vibraphone solo for District Music Festival. We are just getting the results back, and they're going to be emailed out to the students and to all the directors in our district. I was the chair for our festival this year, which made it even more of an adventure. Learned a lot from it, even though it's something I hope we never have to repeat again. So let's hope that next year we can have an actual live festival across the state. So here's Parker Stocklin with his piece.
Thank you.
Alright, hang tight for a sec. We're going to do a set change, and then we're going to do bridge staging. All right, so at this concert normally we would have lighter music because it's springtime, and in this case, the students chose Guardians of the Galaxy selections from. So if you see the original movie, it's based on a Marvel comic, and it's fantastic, great soundtrack, lots of oldies from the 60s and 70s, and a little bit of 80s. So I hope you enjoy it. Here is selections from Guardians of the Galaxy.
Thank you.
I'm very proud of them. The next piece I chose, A Little March, by Carl King, on the March Kings. And this is United Nations March. Together and whatnot. We have students that work on that as well, and it was just too much on them too. I mean, there's these kids are trying to graduate on top of trying to navigate through all the protocols and things due to COVID. So it's been a difficult year, even though it may seem somewhat normal, you know? So we're all kind of looking forward to having a break after a bit. So we're going to get him set up here in just a sec, and I think you're going to enjoy this. His solo is absolutely stunning, and I hope I'm not making him nervous by saying this, but I think you'll enjoy it. So, give us a second. Ladies and gentlemen, senior Tanner Curlin, lots of sax with his accompanist, Ms. Mary Ruth Fallon. Please give them a hand.
Thank you.
we try to have upper-level students in that group as much as possible. So why are they combined? Well, about 2 years ago, or a year ago, I guess it would have been 2 years ago, the last spring concert we had in here, May of 2019, we usually try to combine groups together so that the students get an experience with the symphonic band. So a lot of these students that are in concert band are going to be in the symphonic band next semester. And we want to give an experience with some of our seniors because it's a really special experience and you learn a lot from it and it helps the students to step up, as I've heard directly from the kids who have done this in the past. So, this first piece is relatively short, but it's got two numbers in it by Stevie Wonder, and I think you'll recognize them. So here is Stevie Wonder in concert.
Thank you.
right, so this is Rhapsody of Blue by George Gershwin. But before we get to that, it's really great to have a lot of great parents out there who support their students in everything that they do, regardless of what activity may be. And in Ben in particular, we have a lot of active parents that are really wonderful about making sure that their students have what they need, and also support them in making sure they get the job done. We also have those that surprise once in a while. And tonight we have one of those surprises. So Mrs. Ann Gannon, who is the mother of senior Jack Gannon, who is playing trombone back there, is going to be playing the piano solo tonight in George Gershwin's Rhapsody in Blue, and she is fantastic. So would you please give her a huge round of applause, and this is Ann Gannon once again. And here is George Gershwin's Rhapsody in Blue.
Thank you.
Hannah. Wonderful, wonderful. So first things first, we're going to go over a letter, and to letter in band, students have to be active outside of class, essentially. So that can be anything from doing pep band, which earns points, and we only had 3 pep band games that we performed for this year, and we gave each student 5 points for each game they attended, so 15 points if possible. They can also do a solo or solos at district festival, or ensembles at district festival. Jazz band counts as an ensemble as well. And being in jazz band in general for the entire year also earns points. So there's a lot of ways you can earn points for band. So for first year letters, those students have to earn 45 points in order to letter. And they are the following in alphabetical order. Please hold your applause until I'm finished reading the list. So here's first year letter recipients. Not all are freshmen. We have Audrey Bledsoe, Tasha Dunbar, Josh Edelin, Dawson Gerardo, Dyson Linden, Adina Lockwood, Taylor Bouton, Isaac Sandler, and Joe Thatcher. Please give those students a round of applause. Okay, guys. So, first-time letters means that you can go through your first year and not letter, and then letter your senior year. I had a student that lettered all 4 times senior year, and that was last year, which is kind of hilarious, actually. So sometimes it takes a little bit for students to get going. So those students will receive a cloth letter if they haven't already got one from another activity, and also a pin that says band. Okay, for second year letters, we call that a minor pin. It's like a medal almost that you put on your letterman jacket. And those students have to earn a cumulative of 85 points. So the points that they accumulated their first year carry over to the next year, and they just keep adding to it. So this is 85 points or more, and they have to be a sophomore or a junior in order to get this. So this is Betsy Bledsoe, Merritt Felton, Sam Huckaba, Faith Lindstedt, Runyon Matthews, Anita Shastova, and Nikki Thatcher. So give them a hand. Third letters for major pin is a humongous pin. It's got a big ribbon on it and a little medallion. It's pretty cool. And those students have to earn a cumulative of 120 points or more and have to be at least a junior in standing in order to get this letter. So these are the following students that will receive that letter and that pin: Rafe Dugan, Gabe Felton, Jonathan Graycheck, Riley Hauser, Haley Huff, Tim Liebig, Jasmine Ramirez, Juan Sanchez, and Nikki Thatcher. And fourth letters, so you have to be a senior in standing and have 180 plus points. We have seniors that are in the 300s or more in range, which is pretty impressive, and that happens every year. And so the following recipients of that are Eva Bruce, Connor Bullens, Tanner Crow, Jack Gannon, Coulter Gerardo, Madison Harris, Grayson Malone, Alec McLaughlin, Kyle Miller, Parker Stocklin. That's all. Mentioned they received a gold bar, just a little gold bar. All right, one thing that I started a few years ago was for students that have been in the band program here at Flathead High School for 4 years, they receive another pin, a special pin. So if you do the letter, you can still receive a special pin, and that pin depicts whatever your primary instrument is. And it's a full color pin, it's pretty cool. For percussion, they get a drum set, which is, I think, the coolest pin out of all of them. And if you're a bassoon player, those are pretty sweet too. But we have no bassoonists, so you know somebody might want to switch because that's a great pin to get. So anyway, here we go. So the following seniors have been in the program for 4 years in alphabetical order here at Flathead High School. And that is Eva Bruce, Connor Bullens, Tanner Crow, Jack Gannon, Coulter Gerardo, Madison Harris, Sam Huckaba, Grayson Malone, Alec McLaughlin, Kyle Miller, Juan Sanchez, Parker Stocklin, and Nikki Thatcher. Allstate. And it happens in different major cities across the state every year. And this year was supposed to be in Great Falls, and Allstate involves the best of the best, so to speak. If you audition, if a student auditions for Allstate band, orchestra, or choir, and they get selected, they are part of an elite group of students. And it's an incredible honor band or honor orchestra or honor choir experience. It's something the students really look forward to if they make it, and they bring back a lot when they come back to the program. They really enhance the program when they come back and join us again. We had three students that made it this year, and unfortunately there was no honor band. It was just an honorary thing this time, so the state actually sent all the students a little trophy or plaque, I believe it was, with their name on it. And fortunately, ours did not have any typos. There was a number that we got in the choir that had typos. They misspelled names and things like that. But fortunately for the band students, we didn't have an issue there. So we had a three-time All-Stater who made it this year, a senior. That was Eva Bruce on clarinet. And she will receive a pin for All-State. There's a little All-State pin. And then we have a first-time All-Stater, trumpet player, Coulter Gerardo, also a senior. Very cool. And then we also have, occasionally we have eighth graders that audition, and then as freshmen they end up getting into All-State too, which is very special. So it's hard to encourage that when I'm not over at the middle school, but we try to get as many students as we can to try out. So this year we had a freshman French horn player, Dyson Linden, also. Lots of love. All right, so we want to honor all of our students and recognize all of them, because not all of them were mentioned in all the other awards that they just gave out. And so we have some flowers for our seniors, and we're going to have each of them come up and grab a flower, because we want you to be recognized, and we want you all to please acknowledge them as well. So this has been an incredible group of students to work with since freshman year. They were on fire about everything, and it carried all the way through all 4 years. You know, it's waned a little bit because, you know, when you become a senior, you get a little bit of that senioritis and just want to get out of here, you know? So I totally understand that, but they've always wanted to be challenged since day one, and they've pushed me quite a bit too. This last piece, Rhapsody in Blue, tough piece, you know, even though this is an abridged version, difficult piece, but they took to it like crazy. Even though the last few weeks there's been IB testing and tennis and track and kids have been out of school and out of class, it's been difficult to get the full group together. Even today for the concert, we had probably about half in rehearsal. So it was tough, but these kids are resilient because they're that good. So they deserve a lot of recognition. So here we go. There are 15 seniors that have stuck through this program, and I'm so proud of them. So proud of them. You're going to be missed greatly. Big shoes to fill. Don't mess up. Here we go. All right, here we go. Eva Bruce. Connor Bowens. Matthew Danielson. Walter, whoops, Jack Gannon. I'm sorry. Coulter Gerardo. Sam Huckabee. Faith Winston. Grayson Malone. Kyle Miller. Juan Sanchez. Parker Stockland. Nikki Thatcher. Chloe Dudon. We got to go on to our big awards now. We have four large awards that we give out each year, and they involve plaques that are on the wall outside of the band and choir rooms and orchestra rooms. So if you go out there, even if the band and choir rooms are locked, you can still look at those plaques and see the names of students from the past that have gotten these awards. But we also give the students something as well, as a memento. So, the four awards are the National School Marching Band Award, the Louis Armstrong Jazz Award, Patrick S. Gilmore Band Award, and the John Philip Sousa Band Award. So, a little disclaimer. Normally, I spend time writing out paragraphs on every student so that I get everything right. And again, time was not on my side this time. So I'm going to do this off the cuff. Here we go. It's going to get a little scary. Let's see what happens. So first of all, I'd like to mention that the students that are going to be receiving the National School Marching Band Award, the Louis Armstrong Jazz Award, and the John Philip Sousa, I'm treating those as top awards in the program. So even if you get the Jazz Award, there's more to it than that. These students, and I can't say this enough, these students are so amazing. This is an exceptional group of young people, these seniors. Exceptional. And I don't say that lightly, because I'm very careful about how I choose my words in front of my students. I don't just encourage them simply because, well, okay, let's have some fun, guys. Let's really work hard. There's more to it than that, and you got to push them in order to get to that point. These guys have actually been a dream to work with, a dream to work with, because they work hard already. If you say, we need to work on this part, blah, 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 they will take their instruments home, instruments plural, not just one, and work on those parts and come back and have it ready to go. Is it perfect all the time? No, they don't always take them home, but they do. They're consistent about that, and they're incredible role models. And again, like I said, big shoes to fill, you know? And, all right, I'm not gonna say anymore. So, here we go, let's just move on. So we're gonna start off with the National School Marching Band Award. 2 years ago, this was a brand new to this school, because we were trying to take marching band into a different direction and just trying to make it a little bit more of something that is more respectable and that students look at it as something that's like, yes, we're gonna go for excellence for marching band, that sort of thing. So CIDA at this award, which is a national award, so this is not something that you just simply buy and then you engrave it with the National School Core Award. The students who get this award end up on a national register and it's there forever, which is pretty cool. So the student can go back and go, oh wow, I'm with all these people. Oh, who got it in 1967, and so on and so forth. So the student who is receiving this award is an extremely hard worker, is definitely fit for the position that he or she did this for the last 3 years. He did for the last 3 years. And everybody knows exactly who that is. His leadership qualities are natural. I mean natural. So much so that our staff that we've brought up for the last few years have said, yeah, you gotta keep this guy. I mean, he's got some skills there that are innate. You know, he can do this without really thinking about it. I mean, he's so good that during marching band camp, he is the guy that everybody listens to. I am not that guy, okay? They listen to him. So, and that is the drum major's job. And so I've hoped throughout those 3 years that other students that have looked up to him would follow suit, so that if they want to be drum major, they're like, okay, that's the model we have to follow. So he is the model. So ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to present Alec McLaughlin with the National School Marching Band Award. And he will receive a beautiful plaque as well, being engraved as we speak. All right. Next is the Louis Armstrong Jazz Award. We had two jazz bands this year. We had Jazz 2, which ended back about a month and a half ago, which met 2 days a week. And then we also had, of course, as you saw, Jazz 1, which still meets 3 days a week, and we're going to actually meet less. There's no rehearsal tomorrow, as a reminder. Yes, right? Okay. And they have one more gig. They're going to perform on Wednesday, May 26th, during intermission of the Scholarship Awards Night. So if you're here for that, you'll hear them during intermission. So they get one more shot, which is pretty awesome. So the Louis Armstrong Jazz Award is named after the famous trumpet player Louis Armstrong. And it goes to one or two students in the program who are outstanding in that genre. Again, it was agonizing to try to figure out who or who should get this award. Because there's so many great students in this program. But I think these two individuals deserve it this year, and they have been the example, once again, for jazz style and also a role model to others, you know, in terms of work ethic and things of that nature. So I'd like to present this award, which is also a beautiful plaque, which to Grayson Malone, again for the second year in a row, and Alec McLaughlin. Once again, these two awards that I just mentioned, Jazz and National Marching Band, we're counting that as being something that encompasses everything that these students stand for. Now, before I get to the John Philip Sousa Band Award, which is our top award for band, we have another one, which is given out to as many students, and in particular seniors, who are just as worthy, but there's just a certain edge that the person that gets this, the John Philip Sousa Band Award, you know, makes that person get that award, if that made any sense. I think I'm rambling now. But here is the Patrick Gilmore Band Award. These are students that are heavily involved in the band program from freshman year all the way through senior year. Once again, extremely great role models all the way around. Great people. Honestly, I mean, the future is in good hands with all of these individuals. We're giving this out to six students, six seniors, because it was like, I can't choose one or two or three. I have to choose more. So they all receive a plaque, and their names will go up on the wall outside the band and orchestra and choir rooms. So here they are. Don't be surprised. Eva Bruce. Connor Collins. Colton Gerardo. Max Harris. Kyle Miller. Parker Stockton. Congratulations. The John Philip Sousa is considered the top award for bands across the entire country for every high school. And again, there's a national registry, which is pretty awesome. And I put in those names every year, and they go on that registry forever. So this goes to one student every year, not two. It has to go to one. There's specific rules in there. You can't order another trophy. It has to be one a year. And sometimes the students that are the best role models are the ones that don't really get out there much and flaunt it. You know what I mean? So, and this individual is exactly that. And this individual also plays multiple instruments extremely well, spends hours in the practice room here at the school and at home. That's all he does. Last time I talked to his parents, they said that, yeah, that's all he does at home is listen and play music. That's all he does. And you saw him earlier tonight playing that amazing solo. So tonight, very well deserved, the John Flip Sousa Band Award goes to Mr. Oh my gosh, Tanner Crow. Saxophone professor actually adjudicated his solo. He hasn't got the results yet, but the guy was gushing all over the comments, you know, saying, yeah, you know, before I record the video, this is what he wrote down in the comments, before I record the video, I'm just going to sit back and listen to this with my eyes closed for a while. Very impressed. So there you go, Tanner. Well done. Right? And now we're going to wrap this up. Thank you all for coming out tonight, and thanks to everybody who made this all happen. And don't forget about graduation. Now we have a special alumni who's going to come up on the stage here. This is Miss Anna Schultz, who's going to play piccolo with us on Stars and Stripes Forever. Please give her a hand. once again, ladies and gentlemen, have a wonderful